Got a family to feed, chasing my... Could this be the year that 2K brings us a brand new archetype system? I think this is and will be the year of player control. And let me tell you why. What it do? What it do? Welcome back to another dope gaming experience with you. Know who? I go by the name of Bake, and I'm part of the greatest clan in the land, TRT. And if you don't know, you better ask your girlfriend. How y'all doing? It is your boy Bake. Thank y'all so much for the prayers and the love. I'm getting better day by day, man. We'll be back soon to give y'all the litty content and streaming and things like that. But until then, you know, we got to do what we got to do. It's Wednesday. Y'all know what time it is. It's Wish List Wednesday. And it's time to talk about 2K's potential brand new archetype system that's coming to 2K20. And let me tell you why I believe that 2K20 is going to be the year of something different, the year of giving us back player control. Number one, it's because 2K rarely does the same thing all the time. Only 18 and 19 was the only year where you had the same archetype system, but the only difference is that you got different badges than you did from last year. And this year, I truly, firmly believe that 2K is going to give us a brand new system. I don't know what it's going to be, but I know that it's probably going to be something in regards to giving players back the control to create the player we want to create. Y'all remember the 2K14, 2K15 days where you got to choose your player and based off, you know what I'm saying, your attributes that you increase determine what kind of style of player you was? I think that was the best type of 2K because everybody was unique. You had the potential to be like a sort of Kevin Durant demigod. You had the 7-foot dribblers who can dribble, post, shoot, and everything. But the only things that made it dope, everybody could make the player that way. You get what I'm saying? So there was no distinction, only with skill. If you was good, then your player stand out. If you wasn't, then it didn't matter if you had a 7-foot demigod. You still wasn't getting buckets. It wasn't until 2K16, 17, 18, and 19 where people pretty much start making the same style of player, the same style of builds. You know, in 2K16, it was a little bit more different because you had inside, outside, and balance, right? But the great thing about that, you had the potential to get all the badges. You had to grind for it, and so that made your player unique. And these other years, you know what I'm saying, in 2K17 as well, even though they came with these specific archetypes, you still had the potential to get all the badges. So that still made your players unique. And so when 18 and 19 came out, it was the year when E-League was introduced, so they put caps on people and they made us play the game how they wanted to play. And really, a lot of people wasn't really cool with that. And I really truly believe that 2K is starting to hear us and listen to us, hopefully. And I think this will be the year where they actually give us the opportunity to give us back player control. I do believe that you should put caps, but I'm tired of people can't get into 99 this or 99 that. If I'm a 99 overall, I should have a lot of more opportunities to have more attributes up closer to 99. I want to be able to feel like I can create a LeBron James build, a Kevin Durant build, or any one of those builds that are really cool. And you want to feel like you can beat that player. I don't feel like I can be dominant. I feel like everybody has their caps. Everybody has their limits. And that's not realistic because there's people like Kevin Durant who is just unstoppable. They can rebound, shoot, dribble, post. They can do all those things and play defense. And I think 2K needs to give it back to us to be able to feel like we can create those players. I really think they should give us the opportunity to get all the badges. You know what I mean? Like every badge except, you know, you can get your shooting badges. You can get those badges depending on your archetype. But at the same time, you can get other badges like defensive stopper. Let me grind for that badge. I think everybody should get defensive stopper because everybody should be able to have a defense in their package. Like, you know what I'm saying? But I really feel like 2K is going to give us what we want this year, and this year is going to be the year because they've already did the same thing twice, and they rarely do they do the same thing three times in a row. I would be shocked if they do the same thing over and over again, because you know what happened when they did the same part over and over again the damn game pretty much died. It was whack. It was cheeks. And so I think this year that this is going to be the year back for the players. This is going to be the year that we want. It's going to be the year that we ask for. And I think archetypes are going to be different and unique in their own way. I don't know what way, but I think it's coming back to player control. I like the days where we get to choose what we want to upgrade. I like the days where we can almost get all the badges based off grinding and getting those badges. You know, but y'all let me know in the comments below. You see me cook that dude up again, man. I'm still out here getting these buckets. I love y'all. Live life, stress less. You're rocking with one of the best. Without the man upstairs, my life would be a mess, man. Hey, 2K, it's time for a new archetype system, and I know you're gonna do it for us, man. It's your boy Bae. Peace. Magical, feeling. Got a nigga, spend it. Money all on your own. Drop it down, hit the floor, do the splits, move it slow, bring it back up again, turn around, let me see you.